and stuff. Okay, I'm also apologize because my talk is really offline of the entire section, but Adri told me that that's the only place available. And I'm sorry for this, but I'm going to talk about anti-cancer mechanism naked mode, a little bit different. Everyone was talking about these sections. And first of all, the few words about naked MORAD, probably most of you know some doesn't know what's naked MORAD. Some people call it one of the most ugliest creatures in the world, but we would like to think that this really cute and cool animal. And I hope by the end of the talk, at least you'll not love it, but maybe at least like it or respect it. And a few things about what is this animal. It's a rodent. And it's the size of mouse. The average body mass is 30 grams. But it lives 30 years, 10 times longer than mice. Can you imagine if you extend the human lifespan 10 times? That's why that going after the mechanism which allow this animal live 10 times longer than mice. The other interesting feature is eusocial mammal. Actually here what you can see, this is the queen, this is the pups, a lot of her babies, and this is the workers so taking care of the pups. But this 30 years maximum lifespan is only, not only for queens, but also for workers. They all live for 30 years. And actually when queen dies, the one of the females from the colony will take place of the queen. It means they can exchange the roles in the colony. But a really interesting point of these creatures that they never developed cancer. And this observation was done in the colony of 800 animals. And there was no cancer was observed in that colony. Which is quite interesting because like mice live 10 times longer and never get cancer. And we are going after that anti-cancer mechanism in naked mora. And first of all, we start by the isolation of the primary fibroblasts from naked morad. And of course, we have the mouse control. Primary fibroblasts, again, when you grow them in culture, you have the sparse culture. In 7 days, they are rapidly growing and they fill the plate. It's like a monolayer on the plate, this stage called confluence. It's triggered earlier contact inhibition. This is really powerful anti-cancer mechanism. It prevents the uncontrolled cell proliferation. It means the cells will not be able to grow on top of each other. And if you look at all the cancer, most of the cancer cells, they lose earlier contact inhibition. It means they'll grow on top, they'll pile up and actually kill the cultures. But primary cells, they form this nice monolayer. When you isolate the primary cells from naked mole rat, they are growing a little bit slower than the mouse cells, but this is the maximal cell density that we can get on the plates. And we call this stage early contact inhibition because that's a much less cell density. And this is just a nice pictures, but what about quantification of the cell number on the plate? We got this cell growth, this is days in the culture, this number of cells per plate. And the mouse cells, they're rapidly growing in the beginning, and then they enter in this plateau, earlier contact inhibition, and then they stop proliferation. In case of naked mora, they're much slower growing, but they still enter in the same plateau, a similar type of plateau, but we call it earlier contact inhibition because the cell density is much lower on this. The cells just start touching each other, and then they stop to proliferate. Actually, you confirm this cell cycle arrest by thymidine incorporation and BRD incorporation, it's really the cell cycle arrest. It's the same true for skin fibroblasts and for lung fibroblasts. Lung fibroblasts are just a little bit bigger, that's why it takes a little bit less cells to occupy the same plate. But also we obtain one spontaneously mutation in the cell lines, one of the naked mora, which start to grow rapidly and goes to the same cell density as the mouse cell lines. It should probably tell us it's really some kind of mechanism involved in this early contact inhibition, which should probably get mutated in one of the cell lines. It's most of the anti-cancer mechanism, they usually start to activate it in the early, late development. Let's say telomerase expression in human, and telomerase expressed on the early embryogenesis, and then it shut down as an anti-cancer mechanism. We start to hypothesize that maybe the same happens for naked mole at early contact inhibition. And for this purpose, we isolate the embryonic naked mole fibroblast. That was quite challenging because for this purpose, you have to kill the queen. And when you kill the queen, all the females start to fight in the colony in order to take the place of the queen. It means the colony will be collapsed for a while. But nevertheless, we got the several embryonic culture, and you can see they're filling the plates at much higher cell density. This is the naked mode adult fibroblast, this is the embryonic fibroblast. And again, the quantification of these results, this is our mouse reference, the maximal cell density that we can get from the mouse fibroblast. And this is the naked mode embryonic earlier passage. And what you can see, the interesting, that after several passages, population 11 and 14, we start to see appearance of this early contraindication. The cells start to reach less and less cell density on the plate. And this is the reference for our naked mode adult fibroblasts. They reach an even lower level than those, approximately the same level. Now it was clear for us, okay, it's some kind of anti-cancer mechanism which is evolving naked mode. And we would like to know what kind of mechanism. And what we know from the research on mice and human, the two really powerful tumor suppressors involved in the control of the tumor progression is RBMP53. And we decided to study RBMP53 pathways in naked mole. And for this purpose, we use viral SV40LHT antigen. The beauty of this huge protein, it binds and inactivates both RB and 53 at the same time. We also have the mutants of the LHT, K1 and Delta434, which inactivates only P53 or RB proteins. First of all, before we go to the further experiments, we'd like to test this LHT is still active in naked mole, because we know it's active in human and mouse, but nobody works in naked mole except for us, and maybe a couple of other ones. First, we just took naked morad fibroblasts and we co-transfect them with RB reporter plasmid and the LHT or Delta434. And looking at the luciferase expression of reporter plasmid, and in this case, the RB repressed that promoter, and you can see when you remove the RB with LHT or Delta434, the expression of this reporter goes up, which means it's active. In the case of P53, it was P21 promoter, which is upregulated by P53. Again, when we removed it by LHT and K1, it goes down compared to the GFP controller. It means the LHT works perfectly on naked morad cells. And the next stage, we just took the naked morad cells, we transfected them with LHT and the mutants, and monitored the cell density on the plate. And again, you can see the GFP are just negative control, and the single mutants, which will inactivate RB or P53, have no effect on the cell density, but look what happened to LHT. The cells start to reach almost the same density like a mouse skin fibroblast. It means we completely inactivate this earlier co-inhibition effect by the overexpression of LHT, or inhibition of P53 and RB at the same time. The similar results we got from the also lung fibroblasts, again, a bit low density because of the size of the cells. But we are really curious about this because you have to remove P53 and RB at the same time. Why is not enough to remove only one? And we are thinking that probably when you remove RB, the cells will be proliferating at high cell density, but probably it may die in the culture if second mechanisms existed in the system. And we decided to test it. We measured the level of apoptosis in these transfected cultures. And yeah, we got the apoptosis, because this is our control. When you remove RB or P53, the apoptosis level going up on these cultures. When you put LHT, the apoptosis going down. It's true, yeah, the cells is dying. Something else is sensing that in culture is wrong. And not let it to proliferate to high cell density. We decided to remove the apoptosis by the apoptosis inhibitor, the general apoptosis inhibitor. It's a caspase inhibitor, ZWAD-FMK. And actually here, this green bar, that's we're applying ZWAD-FMK in the culture, and you can see we're able to suppress it to the basal level of the apoptosis. And now we can do the same experiment with cell growth in the presence of ZWAD-FMK. Again, this is just the reference from the previous slide. We don't put any apoptosis inhibitors, and when you put the ZWAD-FMK, everything looks the same except for Delta434. You see these cells, they start to reach much higher cell density than the previous